Obadiah is the shortest Old Testament book. It only has 21 verses to deliver its message of doom. Far less than a book, it's just a 290-word essay in the original Hebrew language. Obadiah is possibly the earliest of the prophetic books and is a dramatic example of God's response to anyone who would harm his chosen people. Just as you swallow up my people on my holy mountain, so you in my surrounding nations will swallow the punishment I pour out on you and disappear from history. Obadiah 6. Hi everyone, this is Tammy Becker. I am the founder of YOU Ministries. Thank you for joining me today as we review this quick book, very small book of the Bible, Obadiah. The theme of Obadiah we are going to see is righteous judgment. As we can see in Obadiah 18, the verse says, "No survivor shall remain of the house of Esau." The time of Obadiah was written between 850 and 840 BC, and the author is Obadiah himself, as the setting is in Jerusalem or in Edom. So the main points that we're going to see in Obadiah is God is going to be paid back the country of, for Adam and attesting and killing Jewish refugees who were running for their lives from the invaders. Obadiah probably delivered the message sometime, but during the 30-year stretch after the Babylonian overrun of the southern and Jerusalem nation of Judah in 586 BC, but before Adam fell to Babylonian in 553 BC. Now, this isn't for certain though, because the identity of the invaders he mentions, many Bible experts say that their best guess is that the Babylonian invasion is a pivotal event for the Jews because it erases the sovereign nation from the world map. So the title Obadiah means worshiper of Yahweh or God's servant of Yahweh. It is the name of the writer of the book. When we connect Jesus in Obadiah, we read that the prophecy that God's people, the Jews, will return to the promised land. Now, Obadiah also predicts the time, the day that the Lord, when the Messiah is the kingdom, will be formed and the Messiah will rule. So as followers of the Messiah, Jesus, we too, we can look forward to the time when Jesus Christ will return and all of God's promises can come true. So Obadiah is in the prophecy division of the Old Testament. It is in the fourth book of the minor prophets and is the 31st book of the Old Testament. So let's jump into the verses. Looking at verses 3 through 16, we see that Adam's distraction here, that the people of Adam feel secure because because of their capital city. Petra is hidden among these high peaks that make their city easy to protect. The people of Adam are filled with pride and self-confidence. Now, their arrogance is evident in verse 3 as they marvel, "Who will bring me down to the ground?" When Jerusalem is attacked by an unnamed enemy, that Edomites do not come to the people of Jerusalem, but instead encourage the attackers, help take some of the people captive, and even plunder the city. Now this angers God, who promises that the Edomites, that though you ascend as high as eagles and though you set your nest among the stars, from there I will bring you down. And that is in verse 4. And in verses 17 through 21, we see Israel's restoration. Those who take pride in their power and defying the Lord will face judgment. Now God's promises to completely destroy the Edomites and restore his people to a place of prominence. So, who were the Edomites? And to answer this question, we need to go clear back to the time of Jacob and Esau. And you can read about these twin brothers in Genesis 27, when Jacob cheated Esau, and then they had to leave home because Esau wanted to kill him. And even after that, the brothers made peace years later, and then they decided to live apart. The family of Jacob became the nation of Israel, and the family of Esau became the nation of Adam, the Israelites. And then in the Edomites, like Jacob and Esau were longtime enemies. So now let's look at some discoveries from the past. The home of the Edomites, in other words, the capital of Adam, was a place that, which is called Petra today, which means rock. Okay, so Petra is one of the wonders of the world today. Only entrance to this great rock city is through this very narrow path. You'll have to look at the pictures. It's fascinating. So it's a mile long. On both sides of this passage are cliffs, a mile long, hundreds of feet high, and the city could easily be defined against or defended against any attackers. And so the Edomites were very proud, and they were very self-confident. So many temples were cut out of the walls of this great rock. In city homes were mostly caves cut out of the rock, and the Edomites would go on raiding expeditions, and then they would retreat back to their great fortress. So they never forgot their bitter hatreds towards the Jews, a hatred that began with Jacob and Esau, like we talked about earlier. So because of this hatred, the Edomites were also always ready to help any army that attacked the Jews. So when the Babylonians attacked Jerusalem, the Edomites helped them catch the fleeing Jews. So what happened to the Edomites? History tells us what happened to the Edomites many years after Obadiah's prophecy. In Obadiah verse 15, it says that you have done it. It will be done to you. Your deeds will return upon you, your own head. And in verse 18, we also see that it says, there will be no survivors from the house of Esau. So what happened to Adam? The Edomites were driven from their rocky home by King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon 5 years after he destroyed Jerusalem. The enemy and the knights fell before the same Babylonian kingdom that they had helped 5 years before when Jerusalem was attacked hundreds of years later. And then after the crucifixion of Jesus, sorry about that, the Edomites completely disappeared from history, just like that. So Bible scholars aren't sure about which invasion of Judah Obadiah refers to in his book, but the message is very clear. God judges those who harm his children or aid in their harm. This was true of Adam in the past, and it will be true of any nation in the future. Life lessons that we can learn in Obadiah. Number one, those who are persecuted, God's people that persecute God's people in the Bible were always brought to justice. Likewise, those who are hostile to Christians today can expect to face God's judgment. Number two, when we see harm being inflicted upon fellow Christians, you should not worsen the situation by abandoning them, but rather come to their aid. Number three, take no pleasure in the misfortune of others. Number four, pride and self-centeredness will reap destruction. So in closing, looking at Obadiah in reference to our own life, on a more positive and personal note, if you are a child of God through Jesus Christ, you are under his love and his protection. Nothing will befall you that isn't under God's directive hand. Ultimately, judgment will fall on all who harm his chosen people, Israel, or his adopted people, or believers in Jesus. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this quick review of the Book of Obadiah. Just remember to come back here next Wednesday when we drop our next episode. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, hit my bell, visit us on the web at youministries.com, and check us out on our other platforms such as Instagram and Pinterest. And don't forget to visit us in our private Facebook group where we study the Bible together, which is called Girl Read Your Bible. Oh, and visit us on Anchor for our podcast. That is called Almighty God and Gospel Girl podcast, and we release those episodes every Thursday. And if you'd like to be a guest, please go to our website and fill out a application for that. So I hope to see you back. God bless you. Have a blessed week. See you next time.